GG. Need to be correct in score for Skady, being at 2. We're gonna be heading right now into random. But what kind of gods are they going to be playing? That's the real question here. That little pause here, they can just think about what gods to play. Can see Shadowfaxx apparently thinking... it's gonna be interesting what he decides to do. I mean, like, curiously enough, they haven't chosen a single Oranos yet. So yeah, I'm exactly thinking about the Oranos right about now as the safest option, because he can be good on any kind of map whatsoever. I think if you're gonna be aiding, you're gonna be ending either with like maybe Set Mirror, for example, could be also interesting idea. Either like expecting Oranos or Set Mirror, that it could be the last game here. Really? They really go in this way. Zeus, because Skady kept Zeus, he was playing the Poseidon on the Mediterranean, so he can be playing that. The Odin from Shadowfaxx is really curious. You're gonna be getting Alfheim, that's... No, well, interesting. That was my favorite map and favorite matchups. Zeus versus Norse on Alfheim, that was kind of fun to play for me always. And you're gonna be starting, unfortunately, on not that high hunt map, it seems to me. So that might be a bit of a problem for the Norse player. But as a great hunt, you could be maybe sending the cowies in there, getting the extras to begin with. But nonetheless, not gonna be choosing to do so yet. Maybe we're gonna be hoping for a few more cowies to be staying a bit safer. So, but really unusual matchup to end with. Wouldn't have exactly expected that all that much. But yeah, well, let's see. I guess I'm kind of expecting this is going to be probably heading into a proper Athena rush from Skady. Skady is definitely aggressive. So he will be going for that, I'm assuming. But even if he's not, then definitely viable to be going for Centaur Raiden. So it could be something that might be also quite appreciating, as Skady does have the skill for playing that. So, at this point, of course, Skady running around, gonna be seeing really not much hunt all around. This is gonna be one of the lower hunt maps. There is a relic for Human Pierce vulnerability. That's a really good one. That would be significantly important for Shadowfaxx against all the potential Toxotai coming forward. So, yeah, that is a solid, solid one indeed for him. Okay, so that's gonna be the extra hunt here. Quite plenty of it. You can see Skady, if he's gonna be cheeky, then Skady could be just basically taking everything and migrate into the middle to try to take all that hunt, because his opponent is not gonna be going there all that quickly. And maybe he could be just really cheeky, and he could be maybe even sending like a Jason in there real quick. But nonetheless, that's probably not gonna be happening, nothing like adventurous like that. He's gonna be coming for his own side on the right side. Ah, that Wolfie is definitely gonna be hungry for the villager. That is a dangerous spot to be yet alone. All alone in here. Needs to be running away. Definitely at least knows where the wolf is. So knows where to run away to. So the three extra villages are already heading there. So that he's gonna be able to get rid of that. But at least it's 100 extra food. So for that it's gonna be rather helpful. But still, maybe a bit of a disruption. It could be resulting into a bit of a later advance for him. Free food trickle. No, not the greatest of relics in this game. Food carrying capacity kind of like of the same variety altogether. Now there's probably gonna be one extra relic somewhere maybe in here in the corner, it seems to me, but nonetheless double here to the top side as well. And yet again, and kind of slightly curious right about now, Shadowfaxx is finally moving for the extra hunt. He might be really gathering there for a long, long time, so he has to be hoping he's gonna be advancing quicker than his opponent and not gonna be getting raided there too quickly, because otherwise the great hunt might be slightly not as effective as he would have hoped. Otherwise the gold on the left side is fairly good, considering the front TC in there, and if he's gonna be able to capture that, then definitely plenty of gold mines available as well, as the back TC so far not visible, but probably about here, as there are not all that many extra spaces where it could be, as the front TC for Skady can basically just pick whichever is gonna be his, pretty much same for his opponent, and yeah, well, that's exactly what's going on here. Okay, so this goal is rather nice for Skady, has to be said. Close by to the base. This one is kind of different, or the same. Not different, rather the same. So, liking that one. Liking the duo of the goals for Skady, because especially as a Greek, he should be able to have few options how to secure it for himself. As he's moving all the way to the top, and I hope he's not going to be moving too many villages there, because that's only two deer. That's only 300 foot, and if he doesn't have secondary plan, like moving and stealing the hunt from Shadowfaxx, then that's heading into maybe a bit of a problem for him a bit later. But nonetheless, Oh, that's a nice gold as well. Right now for Shadowfaxx, as he's already working his way into wall in this part of the map, and especially the tower. As he's already advancing through Freya for about like 440 advance. The opponent is gonna be just getting Jason before advance, and since we are looking right about now, those two guys praying, then it's probably gonna be Hermes for him in the end. And not the standard Athena rush, but he's gonna be just trying to raid his opponent to death. So there we go, it's gonna be about now resulting into what? The moment of truth. Second villager coming to the left side. Ah, it's gonna be the Hermes. I'm kinda thinking he's actually also choosing to go Hermes rather than Athena because of the low hunt map. It definitely helps for Athena rush to be having a lot of food, and he doesn't exactly have that much of it. He's gonna be having some chickens. He doesn't have all that many cows, only 4. That's also not such a high number for him. And it's only like basically 600 food. So I'm thinking that's gonna be also another factor to the decision why he's going rather for the more safe option in here. And for the centaurs, he's obviously gonna be having plenty of favor, plenty of wood, but the advance is yet again gonna be kinda later. So, kinda curious how this is gonna be playing out, because the advance is about 35 seconds after. Nonetheless, that's gonna be relic for cheaper myth units. That's rather nice. Whoa, imagine if actually Shadowfaxx scouted that. Or rather, Skady scouted that. Not entirely certain if it was him. I think it was actually the Shadowfaxx who saw it. But nonetheless, that's gonna be already Forest Fire. And it's a rather good one, because that was the safe forest right about now for his opponent. This one is not safe anymore. Quite far away. At this point, this one, not bad, but he doesn't have the tower here. Look at where the towers are. There is no tower anywhere nearby, so this is pretty much unsafe. But also another part that could have been right now going on already, as the Valkyrie is gonna be bolted, is also that if he used, for example, the Forest Fire on this, he'll be just basically opening this gold wide open and allowing himself to be raiding a whole lot easier on through gold. So plenty of tactical options here, and all of them are having some kind of sense. Not yet, well, pretty much up to you what you're gonna be choosing and what you're gonna be thinking that is gonna be a bit better. You can see right now still plenty of hunt here, and he's gonna be already getting raided. So as I said, this hunt doesn't have to be all that strong, the great hunt, and right about now is actually gonna be Skady who's gonna be taking it, as he has just finished, and he's gonna be right now heading to the bottom side for all of this. Oh well, that's gonna be how much still left here? 400 food, that's rather good. If he's gonna be risking it though, it seems like that he's kinda not wanting to. Slightly interested in that, but nonetheless, all the way to the bottom, we are gonna be looking at longhouses still being made, and apparently this is gonna be full horsey, at least so far that we can see. Interesting decision against, of course, somebody who is quite prone to placing a lot of hoplites into the battlefield, as the bit of a scouting, or the scouting wall in rather, solely protecting the berries. Maybe could be even position one here, just to make completely sure that he's gonna be safe in there. Still having the chickens all the way to the back. The army is gonna be getting stronger. He's gonna be right now positioning the granary here. I hope he doesn't hunt delete this one. It's kinda close, but the battle is already underway. There are gonna be even a few villages in here. Problem is, the Shadowfaxx doesn't have all that many heresies. He's having literally two so far that we can be seen here on the battle. And he certainly needs a bit more of them, because those centaurs are gonna be coming up in much bigger numbers. As he's getting ready about now, Sylvan Lore. But otherwise, only that combination with a few hoplites on top of that. Still pretty solid. Something that you don't see really that often, as often when somebody's going for centaur raiding, they're gonna be basically going exclusively with that, only a bit later. A few minutes later, they're gonna be switching to something different. But right now, this combination could legitimately be working for him. He's even gonna be dropping Archer Wrench right nearby. So maybe he's not even interested in all that many of them. Just basically to slightly trick his opponent into thinking that he could be going for them a bit more heavily. Not yet, well, nonetheless, being another having that Archer Wrench so aggressively into the middle. Oh, he kind of forgot about the wall here, didn't he? Because right now they're going quite a long way around here. Around all the forests, if they want to be going there. So maybe could be slightly optimizing that position on the map. But nonetheless, we are going to be right about now heading into probably quite a solid defense right now for Shadowfaxx, as he doesn't have all that many options where to raid. Nice walling though. You can see a few throwing axemen already prepared in there. And there is a bit of opportunity on the gold, but probably nothing all that long lasting. Especially considering that there is, for example, this gold, and that might also easily vault about there and there. And fairly safe for Skady, basically, from now on. Nonetheless, also plenty of walls all across the map, just this one not getting finished, unfortunately. Yeah, everybody just gonna be walling themselves away from the opponent. There it is. That's gonna be finally some kind of good trading by Shadowfaxx. He was able to find the villages, really good positioning of the horses to deal as much damage as possible. And while he's probably gonna be killing only like one or two villages now, on the next batch, maybe getting just a whole lot better in there. And he's basically just softening them up. Obviously, the Geek cannot heal here. And therefore, you're gonna be waiting for the inevitable secondary raid going a bit later. So probably you can be just continue with this yet again. Those centaurs, they will be doing some damage, but maybe one villager could have been killed. But he decided to be waiting for a bit better option for him, a bit better battle. As unfortunately, he's gonna be losing a temple. So he might be in for a bit of a problem as he's... Oh, he's out of gold. And the second goal is safe. Third one and fourth one as well. So he doesn't have problem with that really. But in the middle of his base, he's maybe in for a bit of a trouble, but still, he doesn't have to be worried about the attack as heavily, because there is no restoration, and with the towers already up, it's gonna be becoming a whole lot more easier for him. Problem is, that he needs to be getting back with the horses. Now, so far, he's at least going for a bit of raiding, but he's gonna be losing the tower, unfortunately, even with a few houses on top of that, and not out of the question completely, that maybe even the TC could be under attack quite soon. Nonetheless, there's gonna be already right now coming forward, the armory, and you can see Heroic Age is gonna be also on the way for Shadowfaxx. Whereas for Skady, you wouldn't be expecting that all that much. Just gonna be waiting for the next age a bit later, because of course Classic Age is quite strong for the Greeks. But that Skady army here, and especially Skady economy, is gonna be rather good. But problem is that he's gonna be needing some kind of defense, and he doesn't have exactly have that. He really doesn't have any kind of safe gold at this point. Can see a bit of raiding on the left side, getting raided here in the middle, that's the base army. And the gold mine, luckily for him, so far is safe, for the time being, but not entirely for that such a long time. And does he have a temple? Oh, he's missing temple for the free giant, that's kinda bad. I don't think actually Shadowfaxx has realized that yet. No, that's gonna be already too late, he doesn't have that much infantry to basically build it up. So he's gonna be missing the free mythical unit, that's actually a significant one against the Greek here. As he could be certainly helpful in somehow managing the crowd. But nonetheless, plenty of buildings are right now getting lost all around. And of course, even with the Heroic Aging, not gonna be getting the free one. And of course, with the army also getting stronger, this is gonna be resulting into even Shadowfaxx casting the Frost right off the bat. And he's gonna be trying to right now fight that? Why? Yet again, run away! Go and raid, for example, I don't know, this. Just check it out, if maybe there's some kind of unit there, that is a hoplite actually hidden in the forest. Or basically go for the raid on the gold, as your opponent does have quite good gold mines. And certainly at this point, you're not gonna be doing any kind of significant damage to deal with this. So basically all infantry, go for the build up, that's a good idea for the hill fort, to get rid of the gold mine. But in the end, the horses could be just switching to get rid of the hoplites, who are right now single-handedly keeping this down quite confidently. So of course, the Frost not exactly dealing anything or doing anything all that much, as the army is gonna be back in about just a few seconds. And this is not looking good for Shadowfaxx at all at this stage, as he's not only not gonna be finishing with the hill fort, but he's also gonna be probably losing quite a good portion of the army in here if it's gonna be played properly by Skady. You can see basically no Hersiers, so therefore the centaurs are absolutely unopposed. There's only one Hersier from the top. Literally that one guy. Not even that one at this point anymore. As yeah, he's just not getting finished at all. We're gonna be seeing what kind of combination. Basically double horses with nothing on top of that. So it's gonna be Shadowfaxx hoping for a rug here. Nothing being researched. Oh. Oh well. Okay, so not gonna be even looking at that. It's gonna be already a GG, and Skady is gonna be the one advancing into the semifinals against Shelty in that. 3-2 in the quarterfinals, and Shadowfaxx, well, yeah, he didn't exactly get, like, the bestest map that he could be potentially getting. And I think it was, like, that tragic overall. But still, the Zeus was definitely quite a good god to be keeping for a decider. And I'm thinking that maybe Shadowfaxx could have been trying something different. Maybe some kind of set. Maybe he could have played. Maybe even the Hades wouldn't be such a bad idea. Against, for example, the opponent Zeus. I mean, like, why not? Wouldn't be too bad. But in the end, Skady played it properly, Shadowfaxx just didn't find the proper strategy to be winning, and therefore, you're gonna be hoping to see him in some other tournament. You can see definitely not any kind of pushover at all, as he got it into the decider here, and he was definitely looking pretty strong in some of the games. Skady, well, both of the players used the home maps properly. They both won their two home maps, So that was very well done in as far as the preparation there, and going with that line of thinking, Pat decided that Zeus versus Odin, that was already going to be quite an interesting matchup, and the map was maybe slightly better for the Zeus, but maybe just needed a bit different strategy there altogether. And cease my fire, no, attacking the frost is absolutely the wrong decision, because you are doing 1 damage. They are having 99% armor, so you are doing literally 1 damage per each hit. So what you should be doing when you freeze the army, you should be doing anything else than attacking the army. You should be going somewhere else and basically try to raid, because the opponent cannot do anything. He has even frozen army. He's not gonna be deleting it, even though it's a viable option if you are in some kind of situation. But yeah, well, let's go and continue here. I'm gonna be looking at... You could have, for example, seen how much little army he's actually killed there. He just basically dealt barely any kind of damage with how few units he was even having on top of it. But nonetheless, let's continue right about now with going through the postgame. That's 4,000 here, 4,360. The wood is a bit more different, but gold is, of course, quite a different measure in here. But overall, the civilian unit's high. 7 difference, that's quite a bit. But that's also because of the advance, which is basically 4 villages difference, the heroic age, 15 per second, or the 15 seconds, so basically 4 per minute. But there still was a bit of an edge in there for Skady, even though he lost actually villages in the raidings. So that's fairly impressive. Unit skill pretty much the same, but unfortunately the power was already heading for Skady at that point, and without any kind of safe and secure gold for Shadowfaxx, it just wasn't going to be going in any kind of good direction from that point forward. You can see not too many upgrades, but the army was really strong enough for that. I'm not advocating playing Hades into Zeus, I'm advocating what he was having left. He wasn't having Zeus into the mirror, so they cannot repeat gods in this. So basically he used all kinds of good gods already. So either he could have played Uranus, Hades wouldn't be such a bad option either. I mean, like, he's a solid god for Greeks. Greeks basically all three play similarly. So if you're gonna be playing them against each other, that's not much of a difference really. You're gonna be playing, you're still gonna be having a chance in the late game in that. It's gonna be up to the skill if you're gonna be having better map control and such. Zeus obviously is gonna be having a bit of an edge, but it's definitely not like that he's gonna be steamrolling you there. But overall, just the good choice. Gonna be probably choosing something different, but he was confident that the Odin is gonna be a good one, and he was probably hoping for a different map where he would be a freely raiding, maybe gonna be having some kind of better hunt, of course, for him as well. But yeah, that didn't exactly come. You can see Skady chose kind of the correct strategy in there with the centaurs on the low hunt Alfheim here. And that worked towards his advantage rather well. So congrats again to Skady to advancing to the semifinals against Shalty. And good games by Shadowfaxx, and looking forward to seeing him in yet another tournament. So, GG. So let's correct the score, that's gonna be about now 3-2 for Skady. And we can be going right now out of the game as well. And that's going to be it right about now for the stream. There's not going to be any kind of other match right about now going on. So I hope that you enjoyed. Yeah, pretty much. The gold really doesn't say all that much in there. Exactly, Narvi, as you say. It's not that much of a difference in there. As Norse do have expensive units and they are usually going for it quite heavily in there. Especially because of the dwarves, obviously. So it's helping their economy. So that's definitely correct. That was just kind of going randomly through the numbers in there. But nonetheless, as I said, hope that you enjoyed today. The match, the last quarterfinal of AOL Destroyers Summer Championship 2019. We know all 4 semifinalists. You can be watching, for example, the bracket also, if you're interested. And you're going to be knowing that the first semifinal is Joe versus EOP. The second one is going to be Shalty versus Skady. It's going to be already best of 7. So a lot more interesting because they will be having to play a whole lot more different gods, because yet again, they cannot repeat gods. There's gonna be way more of them at this point. So follow through. And if you want to be, for example, watching more of those matches, not entirely certain if I'm gonna be able to, and how many games I'm gonna be able to stream next, but it's certainly possible that I'm gonna be trying to do so. So follow me here on the channel for more games, but otherwise I'm also streaming on Wednesday after 17 GMT community games from Wubly Age of Mythology, so that's always AOM on Wednesday there for me. And otherwise on Thursdays and Mondays, that's usually some other games, some old school games. On Monday it's usually some old school strategies, and on Wednesday, or rather on Thursday, it's more towards RPGs. You can see a bit more information below the stream, the same as the links to Facebook, Twitter, and especially YouTube for past streams, and even, for example, Discord, if you want to be discussing some games that we are streaming here. Otherwise, for community and, for example, even recorded games from this tournament, then visit RTS-Sanctuary.com. That's the home of the Age of Mythology community since 2003 already, so basically all the community knowledge and, like, everything that happened has happened there. So community, strategy guides, recorded games of all players that you can be thinking of from both past and present. So, and if you have some kind of new questions and topics for discussion, definitely feel free to visit us there. Then for scenarios and mods, then you can be visiting Age of Mythology Heaven. That's if you want to be getting some extra graphics, maybe some extra maps or even civilizations, that's a good place to be. And there is Reddit/Age of Mythology. And these games have been played on Wubly, the best place for Age of Mythology and Age of Empires multiplayer, and using Wubly Balance Patch 3.0. So you can have seen, quite interesting with all the gods in there, with the matchups, and especially you can know it if you're gonna be playing it, and maybe even just watching community games somewhere from other streamers. There are plenty of them across the community. But yeah, well, if you want to be playing just the original game with Ansible Studios patch, no problem. Wubly Balance Patch is not compulsory. It's just widely accepted, but you can be playing however you want and enjoy the game, including custom scenarios. As there are, for example, Tinies, Plate, some kind of Settlers, Forest Escape, everything like that you can be seen here. And for example, even Vanilla. So if you want to be joining us for a bit more players to be playing with, if you are, for example, playing on another platforms, then you can be just increasing your player pool this way. And well, that's going to be it at this point. Thank you for watching. I've been Blackadder at Blackadder's Place. Thank you for watching and see you later. And also thank you for the follows today. Kuberte, Greek22 and Illusion to 438 at the end. Well, hope you're going to be having fun with some more streams going forward. See you then.